Welcome to another episode of Mechanics on Duty. Today we have a Jeep Liberty 2002 Sport. The car has a problem. The door is doesn't lock from the driver door. As you can see, passenger side locks unlock, but this one it don't do nothing. The problem that this car has is that the door actuator is bad inside, but in this particular car, the door actuator comes with the hatch completely assembled. So we had to remove all this piece here. That's the door hatch. It comes with the actuator. This is the actuator, the part of the actuator this here, but they don't sell this separate. It comes and can be unit completely. All right, so you can get to the door actuator, we had to remove the door panel completely assembly. And for do that, we wanna remove the door panel right now. We had to start from here first. As you can see inside there, we have a little lock, a little cover. In the back, it's holding a Phillips screwdriver, a Phillips ball. We wanna remove that one there, and we wanna remove that one here. One, we're going to remove the other one. In this car, we might have a little bit problem here because the ball, it looked like the person who worked before in the car, it tightened too much. They go over the lap or the cover. It's supposed to come out there, but let's go private and see what happened there. In this car, everything else in the cover is holding by clicks. What I like to do, I like to put a screwdriver, put my fingers in the bottom, put my other hand here, and go a quick pull. 1, 2, 3. Okay, after you got the cover out, you have to remove the connectors that they're here. One, and it's another one down here. Two. And you had to remove the hinge that's going there. You just remove the lock system from there, and you just push it down, and the cover should be off. Right. After you got the cover off, you want to remove this panel, this plastic panel. in the end, we want to glue it back in the spot. And like this, you're going to have access to the complete latch assembly. But first, let me get the tools that I'm going to need, bring the window up, and I'll let you guys know. Okay, now for continuing taking off the latch, we have to remove these three bolts that they hit, these torques. I'm going to start with one, two, and three. As you can see now, the hatch is loose. Now we're gonna bring it down. We have this spiraling awesome here. Let's go fill it up a little bit more. We had to remove the trail for the window too. It's gonna be this 10 millimeter that is down here. Okay, the 10 millimeter is to remove it. Ready? This is 10 millimeter for the window rail. Now we got the plate in the window rail. Now we can bring this thing down. It's this yellow clips here. This is for this bar that's going up. I'm gonna remove it down here too. This is for the bar, let's go in there. Now you have to play it your way down. You have to play your way here to remove this piece. To remove the window hatch. It's a really tight spot. So the way. But eventually you will get it out. Okay, so you can get the window rail. You have to remove this number 10 here so you can move out of the way. And you have to remove this Phillips bolt is gonna be down here attached. So you can get the window, the door hatch assembly out of it. Now, I know that the problem is the hatch, but if you're going for the same problems, and you just want to make sure before you start doing this thing, because it's like a rank A mechanic work, you can plug it in, and you can test it with the remote before you start doing all that. Like, let's try to lock it, and unlock it. And if you go again, it's gonna lock the other ones. Okay. Now we want to start dropping the parts. As you guys can see, you have 4 liter rods that are going to be connecting to it, but they can color code. Green, yellow, orange, red. So you have to make sure that you remember which one you take off which. This case, the green one, is gonna be for the door handle. The one inside the car, so you make sure that you put that one first. You slice it through, and you make sure that the lock, they get locked with the lock system. This here. Show you guys again. And that's it. Now we're gonna bring the hatch inside and we're gonna continue from there. In the door handle, you wanna have two of them. You're gonna have two of them. You're going to have an orange one, that's for the little one. Make sure it's all the way inside and lock it. And you're gonna have an orange, like a pink one. It's gonna be for the big one, for the main door. Handle outside. Make sure you push it through your fingers. Make sure they go inside. And then you lock. Okay? Now, we wanna go and take the one for the door lock. Slice it through here. Where it belong, and that one is gonna go to the orange one, to the yellow one, my bad. And you just lock it there. Okay, I'm gonna put the yellow, you just have to put the white cover back, and that's it. I wanna put this one here, the torque screws. And I wanna torque this later. Go back in the spot, the two number 10s. Remember the one was here, and the other one was down here. Now I'm gonna torque this and come right back. Now we're gonna make sure everything is working properly. Now you can see that it's locking and unlocking. Now we're gonna test the lock mechanism. One tip that I'm gonna tell you guys before you guys lock the door, always test it outside with the screwdriver first. As you guys can see, the lock is locked there. We're gonna go out, we're gonna test it first, and it releases. Always test the handle before you lock it. Now that you see this is working, you're gonna test to inside, to outside. It's locked, no open, open. So that's mean the repair come out good. Now, if you had the same problem as me, you're gonna have these clips, it's gonna stay in the car. Now we have to try to remove that. We put it back in the panel. Now you make sure that you put the clicks where they belong in the car. Grab it one here. One here. And it's gonna be one here. Right? After that, make sure that you got the numbers first inside. My mistake. First, make sure you put everything back the way it was. This one is just gonna go inside there, and the light gonna lock it right there. Make sure you plug the connectors. After that, we wanna slice it back inside. Make sure you get the top piece for the lock. In this panel, you're gonna have like a little loop that's gonna go here. The panel's gonna sit the top of that. And after that, you just click it in. And that's it. You guys almost finished. Now we're gonna put the screw. Now we want here. The little cover. And the screw that was here, I'm gonna put it. And that's how you replace a door lock assembly and a 2002 Jeep Liberty.